Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner, available for code reviews and on-site training. In this episode, I want to talk about standard out pointer and in out pointer, which were both added in C++ 23, and we will discuss why they exist, what their use cases are. So stay tuned for this episode. Now, before we get going, I do want to remind you that I am planning to give a workshop Monday, September 18th and Tuesday, September 19th at Indice Tech Town in Kongsberg, Norway on C++ best practices. And I am hoping to give the same class again at CVPCon a few weeks later in October of 2023. So make sure you check out the links in the video description for that, as well as my books and other upcoming events. Future Jason here. I did realize after recording this episode that the final result ended up with actually fairly significant undefined behavior in it. So be sure you stick through to the end of the episode where you can see how I solve that problem. So this is outpointer, and I feel like the description of it is a little bit difficult to sort through. So we're going to play with it. And hopefully we will get a meaningful understanding of outpointer and inoutpointer by the end of this episode. Now, at the time of recording of this episode, Visual Studio is the only compiler that supports this feature from C++ 23, and this is April 5th, 2023. This is the sole reason that they exist. They exist to make it easier for you to interact with C APIs. So let's just go ahead and attempt to make some sort of relatively meaningful C API. And it's going to be like, to make sure that we're keeping ourselves honest here, we're going to use an extern C function. And we're going to do something like get data. Now, these things in C are often functions that take a pointer to a pointer, and it's expecting to reseat that pointer. So I'm going to have some sort of pointer to a pointer, and in here, okay, so I was passed a pointer to a pointer to an integer. I malloc memory, that is the appropriate size of the integer. And I am returning this back. So this is the kind of thing that a C API might do. Now, inside of my C++ code, I might have some sort of unique pointer that's existed. And at some point, I need to call this C function. And I want to do this in a smart pointer friendly way. So I am going to call outpointer with my something. And for this to work, I need to make sure that I have the proper version of C++ set, which means I need C++ 23 mode. Now, I should at this point have a pointer to something, to an integer, that is equal to the value 42. And I should have no memory leaks because the unique pointer is going to take ownership of this thing that was passed into me. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and execute this and step through it and see if it does what we wanted it to do. We are on the first statement. Something is currently empty. We have not actually constructed this object. And now something is a unique pointer to the value of 1. And then we're going to go ahead and step in here. And I don't really understand why IntelliSense is telling me that I am assigning to a null pointer, because after this call to malloc, this should very clearly not be a null pointer. It is not a null pointer. It is in fact an address. And then I am going to reassign this value 42, and now I am assigning the pointer that was passed into me the value of this pointer, at which point I have this pointer to a pointer is now pointing to the memory that was just allocated. And then out pointer has constructed for me a wrapper object that automatically on destruction reseats the unique pointer. Okay, so this is the key, is that this creates a wrapper object for you. There we go. So this returns an out pointer t. And the out pointer t is this thing that is constructible from some sort of smart pointer type. And in its destructor, it goes in and calls apply, and it calls reset on your smart pointer. It's just that simple. So it's this lightweight proxy object that acts as a gateway between C++, smart pointers, and C code. Now, this makes me slightly nervous because I have constructed something with malloc, and then I am calling delete on it here. And you're really not supposed to do that. But if the point of this is interacting with smart pointers and a C API, then I don't really see any other way that it could work. So I did enable address sanitizer here, and I don't get any sort of memory errors. So let's just hope that that's doing the right thing. But that is the fundamental idea. So that is out pointer. And the description here allows for a set of arguments. Now, this extra set of arguments are the arguments passed on the reset function. So if we go and look at the reset function description for a shared pointer, we can see that we can pass in an optional deleter or an optional deleter and an optional allocator. And it's difficult to see all this in the documentation. What you really have to do is when you're looking at out pointer, that's the helper function. You really need to look at this part that says it returns an out pointer t, which is declared in the memory header. And from the memory header, we can see what out pointer t and an out pointer do. So this tells you that its destructor resets the adapted smart pointer, and that is its job. So in out pointer assumes that you are passing in a valid pointer in the first place. It releases it before calling reset. So arguably for what we have done, I should have called the in out pointer version, but it's not entirely clear to me how this would differ from just out pointer, because a reset is going to naturally do the release. So we may as well look at the source code for that too, if we're in here. So in out pointer explicitly calls release first and then reset on destruction if it is a resettable pointer. Otherwise it calls release and then it calls the assignment of a new smart pointer object. And if it's just a plain pointer, not a smart pointer, then it simply reassigns the pointer that was passed into it. So comparing this to the implementation for out pointer, it is simply calling reset without explicit release in the first place. Okay, so it turns out that yes, this is in fact undefined behavior. I was not wrong on my intuition there. The fact that I am mallocing and then calling delete implicitly with the unique pointer is definitely undefined behavior. So what we have learned here is that you can't just blindly use out pointer and in out pointer without having some idea what type of allocation function was used to create the resource handle that you passed in ultimately to your function. So in this case, I am calling a C function. I know it is going to malloc memory for me. What I really need to do is pass in a unique pointer that knows how to free instead of delete. So let's go ahead and try to do something interesting with this. Now, we could just say, I want to pass in the pointer free. That doesn't work. That's not a type. If I did the decal type of the function free, then I'm not constructing this thing with a deleter because there's no default constructor for the free function. So I would have to create this with the free function to give it a deleter. All of this just doesn't really work well. The best thing to do in this kind of scenario is to actually take advantage of the fact that we have default constructible lambdas as of C++ 20, and I can create a lambda that expects an int pointer and calls free on that. So now what I have done is I have said, I want you to have a lambda that takes an int pointer, calls free on it, and then I'm asking for the type of this. So this is going to be a unique type, but it is going to be the type that is the lambda that knows how to free an int pointer. And this is going to be default constructible and usable in unevaluated context, C++ 20 features of captureless lambdas. We want to be able to take advantage of that. And now this pointer type passed in here is going to call free correctly instead of calling delete, which was in fact undefined behavior. So let's go ahead and add in a couple of breakpoints and make sure this is doing what we want it to do. Okay, so now the first breakpoint being hit is in fact the one that goes into my getData function. And this is where we're calling malloc. We're creating that value. This is C, remember, so the rules are different than they are in C++ for object lifetime here, extern C function. I believe that is all correct. It should be correct. And then I know that the unique pointer has been reassigned to point to this thing. And then when the unique pointer itself goes out of scope, which is going to be down here on line 29, that's when we're going to get the destructor called for unique pointer, which is going to call our lambda that calls free. Okay, there we go. So just keep this in mind that if you're going to use out pointer or in out pointer with any like external functions, what it's really designed for is the scenario where it takes a custom deleter and knows how to free whatever that resource type was that was created for you via a pointer to a pointer in the function that you called. So don't use this blindly. Make sure you know what you're doing when you use this feature, but if you use it correctly, it really can simplify a lot of things. So thanks for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. Be sure to subscribe, thumbs up, all of the things. I'll catch you later.